working with, let's say, the law of attraction, or you've been doing affirmations and you're getting marginal results, or you're getting like this mixed bag of tricks when it comes to what you're manifesting, there's a reason for this. When most people think of manifesting, if you've been drawn to this content, you may have discovered things like The Secret, and the most prominent law that people think about when they think of spiritual laws is the law of attraction. But there are actually so many more spiritual laws at play that you have to be able to work with and integrate in your daily life in order to manifest consistently. And so I'm going to share an example with you. One of my favorite spiritual laws to work with is the spiritual law of reflection, as above, so below. And what this means is that your inner reality is reflecting outward and creating your outer reality. Now, if you were to solely focus on the law of attraction, and let's say you really, really wanted something, you really, really desire something, and so you work really hard at focusing all of your attention on this one thing, this burning desire, and you really want this thing, so you start creating affirmations around this thing, and you start really focusing on that, that can actually do you more harm than good. Because if you haven't up-leveled your inner reality and you're solely using these spiritual tools like the law of attraction and affirmations to achieve or acquire something because you feel the lack of it, what you're going to do is create more resistance and create more of the lack of it. So the universe is always confirming what it is that you're focused on. So oftentimes people are trying to manifest something because they feel a void, and so they're trying to overcompensate through affirmations and working really hard at the law of attraction and their focused energy, which is great. When you can focus on the things that you want, it's going to work for you. But if you're doing it from a place of lack, you're doing it from a place of insecurity, you're doing it from a place of desperateness, you're doing it because you're afraid if you don't get it, you don't know what to do. So whether it's money, whether it's a new career, whether it's a relationship, if you're stuck in this phase where you are wanting something, what you're really highlighting more to the universe is the fact that you don't have it. And so you actually have several other spiritual laws that you can be working with. There's a ton, but there's specific ones that will help you manifest quickly with ease what it is that you desire, and it will help you do it in a state of flow and not a state of, get out of that state of desperateness, get out of that state of struggle, get out of that state of wanting something or longing for something or desiring something. You really have to put you're putting the carriage before the horse if you are solely focused on trying to achieve what you want, but you're coming from a place of knowing that you don't have it, like feeling that you don't have it, and you're out there trying to manifest it because you're afraid of what happens if you don't get it, or because you want it so bad. And so a way to think of this, one of my favorite spiritual laws, I work with many in my upcoming in my 7-pillar manifesting formula that I'm going to be sharing in the masterclass that I'm teaching on November 26th. So if you haven't hopped on that and RSVP'd, go to the link in my bio or in the comments below or below this video, depending on where you're watching this video, and make sure you jump in on that. I'm also going to be hosting a free energy clearing to help clear some of the blockages that are keeping you from calling in the energy that is going to help you come into greater alignment. Because a lot of times there's blockages in the first three lower chakras that are keeping us in the state of feeling insecure or feeling in a state of worry or not having a solid sense of self, which is going to keep us in this, state of unworthiness or neediness, which is not the vibration you want to be in when you are manifesting. So you really want to shift that energy. So again, check out the link and hop on that if you want. I highly recommend it if you're drawn to this information. But so does this make sense? Because think of law of attraction as gravity. It's always working, right? The law of attraction is always working for you. You're manifesting all the time, whether you know it or not. It's just whether or not you're manifesting consciously. So the reason you're getting a mixed bag of tricks when you're working with, let's say, the law of attraction or just affirmations in general and things like that is because you're focusing some of your energy in a positive way, and so you're getting a little bit of that, but you still have um, these this inner reality that is not in resonance with what it is you truly want. So maybe you'll get it, but you won't be able to keep it. Or maybe, you know, it's always out, it's always away from you. You're always, you're in a state of wanting, and so you're just manifesting more wanting, and so it's always out of reach. It's always in the future. It's never in the now, okay? So if the law of attraction is always working, and it's like the motor that drives the car, it's just like gravity, it's always working, what is it attracting to you? It's attracting to you what you believe to be true. It's attracting to you the stories that you tell yourself. It's attracting to you the beliefs of what you truly believe. It's attracting to you what you fully have faith and knowingness in. It's attracting what you are putting out from the inside out. And so as you up-level your inner reality, the law of attraction is going to draw things to you. And then as you up-level the inner reality some more, the law of attraction is going to draw some more to you. And if you keep up-leveling your inner reality, the law of attraction is always going to be drawing more to you. And so on and so forth. So therefore, your focus is not necessarily on trying to manifest things. Your focus is more on how are you going to become the vibrational equivalent of what it is you truly want and what it is you truly desire. So I hope this video finds you well. If this is something that you're interested in, definitely hop on the masterclass. It's 10X Your Manifesting Masterclass. It's completely free. If you show up live, you're also going to get access to a bonus energy clearing where I work specifically on helping you clear blocks in the first three lower chakras, opening up your heart chakra so you are more open to receiving the abundance, because a lot of times we're blocking the receiving side of things. So you have to be open to receiving too, and I'm really excited to go into detail on this with you. Leave your comments below the video wherever you're watching this, whether it's on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram. Check out the links in my bio if you're on Instagram. Definitely message me if you have any questions, and I will see you soon on the masterclass. Namaste.